Well, hello and welcome to the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. Day 7 of the competition, and it's day 3 of speed skating here at the James Sheffield Skating Arena. This session will be featuring the women's and men's 1500 metres, arguably the toughest of all the distances in speed skating. 18 pairs, well, to be fair, it's 17 pairs in a single going out here in a sprint across 3.75 or 3¾ laps of the 400 metre oval. And it's a race against the clock, not a race against your opponent. As we progress through the pairs, we're expecting the times to get quicker and quicker. Well, it's just been getting a tiny bit chillier here in Lake Placid. We're down to minus 10. We're expecting that temperature just to creep up a little bit through the course of this session. Inessa Shumakova. And Shumakova goes up against Natalia Jabrich from Poland and the Lodz University of Technology. Shumakova from the Kazakh Academy of Sport and Tourism. Pair number 11 in this women's 1500 meters. A cracking start from Jabrich. Get our second split time. And there you go, just inside. Now it's about maintaining this. She's still pumping hard, so trying to pull away from the time set by Kung. First real meaningful challenge here, but you can see that the pole is breathing hard and heavy already.
She's also obtained season best times in each of the last four ISU World Cup events. She's coming down with one lap to go.
So, three quarters of a second ahead, Jabrich moves into pole position. A dead 33 second 400 meters for Jabrich. And she comes into the final bend. This is going to be exceptionally close here. She's certainly going to be up in the medals as long as she doesn't fall. Pumping the arms hard here, double-handed swing to build up as much energy as possible, and a 1.23 lead over the next best, which is Kang Soo-min from Korea. Another track record set from Natalia Jabrich. Pair number 12, Czech Republic's Technical University of Liberec student, Veronika Antosova, going up against Canada's Rose Anne Grenier. Well, they're going to get the bell as they cross the line. The Czech Republic athlete on the inner lane at the moment will switch over to the outer lane. It's going to be a clean transition there, so 15 meters between the pair of them. But you can see Grenier pumping both arms. She's still got bags of energy. She comes into the final straight, trailing at the moment, but on the inner ring. This is going to be tight between the pair of them. Are they going to get into that top three? It's going to be really close here. But just inside, and second and third. Antosova at 206.65 and Grenier at 207.32 puts them into second and third positions, respectively. If you were watching the 1,000 meters, you would have seen Iga Vodashik going out first in a single late entry into the competition. A communication breakdown, I'm told. Went out first, sent the second fastest time, got a silver medal in the 1,000 meters. Vodashik here in a more familiar pairing. A little later in the order, pair 14. The 1,000-meter silver medalist on the inside track, paired up with Marino from Japan. So we get our 300-meter split. What have we got on the cards here? Look at that, half a second inside the time for Vodashik. Just over a lap to go now. Coming up to the 1,100-meter split. Vodashik was half a second ahead of the time. And she's just dropping off a little bit here, but still inside the time, a 33.18, so just starting to slop a tiny bit. But can she maintain this now? Still looking neat and tidy, still looks like she's got bags of energy here. Now she's gonna pump around this final bend. We've had the track record broken twice already. Kung first and then Jabrich. And now Wojciech from Poland in with a shout. 206.19, the time to beat. It's going to be exceptionally close, just over and just outside of the medals. Just didn't have enough in the last 400 to 600 meters was when things started to ease off for Wojciech. So now we go to the final pair. Silver medalist in the 3,000 meters, Park Ji-woo here. And here's another Canadian, Annalise Bourgeois. 206.19, the top time to beat. So Park and Bourgeois underway, a final pair in the women's 1500 meters, challenging for the top three here. Currently filled by Jabrich of Poland and Tesova of the Czech Republic and Grenier of Canada. 207.30, the time to beat to get on the podium. 206.19, the time to beat to get to the top of the podium. Go through our first split here, and Park is slightly ahead. Bourgeois in touching distance. Nice and tidy, nice and neat, just a little wide there from Bourgeois. Park still within 0.2 of a second of the time, currently sitting in fifth place. Bourgeois just dropping off a little bit and is going to have to switch to the outer track now. So really we're looking at the Korean here. Can she challenge that top time set by Jabrich? Again, looking neat and tidy, legs pumping neatly in cadence. There is the pole, the leader looking on intensely. She knows she's guaranteed at least bronze here, but Park Ji-woo is challenging here. Nearly half a second ahead now, and what a split time that was. Fantastic, 32.33 for the last 400 meters for the Korean. She's coming out of the back straight into the final bend, still pumping hard, still moving the legs, still looking very relaxed. She's speeding up, if anything. This is an incredible run from Park Ji-woo. 206.19, the time to beat, as Jabrich looks on. Park Ji-woo, has she done it? Is she going to break the track record? Yes, she is. 1.7 seconds off the time. Absolutely fantastic from Park Ji-woo. Bourgeois not quite in the hunt here, finishing in 11th place, but a new track record and a new champion of the World University Games is Korea's Park Ji-woo with a 204.41. She is the champion. Jabrich having to settle for second place in the silver medal, having set a track record. And it's Veronika Antosova from the Czech Republic in third. But it was all about the final run, and Park Ji-woo, she just got quicker and quicker. So confirmation then, three track records set here in Lake Placid at the James Sheffield Skating Oval. But top of the pile in the women's competition in the 1500 meters, Park Ji-woo from Korea. Right now, it's the men's 1500 meters. We've got 19 pairs coming out. And we expect the times to tumble as we go through the field. Matthew Belloir. And he goes up against Senshu University student from Japan, Arita Motonaga. So pair 15 of the men's 1500 meters. Underway here. Arito on the outside track. Belloir on the inside track. Japan versus France.
Our split time for this pair, Atito at 24.67, Manora at 25.37.
So Arito moving up into a provisional second place. Not too early, really, to call this one.
It is now the bronze medalist in the men's 5,000 meters at the Lake Placid 2023 Fizhou World University Games.
So you can see Arito still strong. Not quite up with Marcotti's time just yet. He was the quickest through 700 meters.
On to the front stretch, to the finish. One lap to go.
So the bell rings. And Arito has moved 3.1 seconds up. So 1:53.061 is the target time set by Park Seng-yung. And Arito Motonaga is pushing hard still. Bronze in the 5,000. He's still working hard, swinging the levers. Can he cross the line in the lead? It's going to be close. He has done it. 2.63 seconds with a spectacular 30-18 final 400 and a provisional 1:50.43 for Arito Motonaga. Currently sitting at the top of the standings, and it's another new track record here at the James Sheffield Olympic skating rink. Kasahara Kataro. That goes up against Finland's Samueli Sumalainen. Pumping super hard, Sumalainen.
Almost 3 seconds off the track record in this pair, 16.
Well, Sumalainen got off to a cracking start, but Kasahara in touching distance as well. Fast start, settled in now. Across the line this time, I'll hear the bell. Indicating 400 meters to go. Kasahara in provisional third. Sumalainen perhaps went out a bit too fast, dropping down to fifth. Kasahara getting huge support from the Japanese contingent here in Lake Placid. He switches over to the outside track to come round the final bend. Top time is out of reach for sure. 1:53.068 to get into the medals. It's not enough for Sumalainen, but a 1:52.62 from Kasahara Kataro is enough for second place. We have three pairs remaining. Laval University student from Canada, David LaRue. Lots of support for the Canadian. He goes up against Li Seung-hyun from the Kung Il University in Korea. So we're underway. You have to say that LaRue is a bit of a 1,000-meter specialist, finishing in the top 10 in the Canadian Senior Championships last year. Bronze medal here in the 1,000 meters a couple of days ago. Li qualified for the these games by finishing in the top three at the Korean selection event for this tournament. Super quick, the fastest time set over 300 meters for LaRue, a 24.11. The Korean Lee staying in contact here. Well, we saw Marcotti leading the way at the 700 meter stage, setting a faster time of 51.56. LaRue has gone out just that little bit quicker, but Marcotti started to drop away in this third lap. Second and a half lap, it was really. Well, gets the bell, still top of the pile ahead of Alito's time of 1:20.25 at the 1100 meter split. A 1:50.42 is the current top time set by Arito, and LaRue is conserving energy on the gliding phase, taking in as much oxygen as possible, coming around the final bend. This is going to be super tight. This is going to be super tight. 1:50.42 to beat. Oh, it's so close, just 0.81 down, just didn't have enough over the last 400. David LaRue moves up into provisional second place. So pair number 18, the penultimate pair, Salt Lake City Community College student representing the USA, William Gebauer, in the inside track. And he goes up against Yamada Kazuya from Takasaki University of Health and Welfare. So we're underway, penultimate pair, 18th pair here, Gebauer of the USA on the inside track, Yamada from Japan on the outside as they come up to their first split time at 300 meters. A 0.7123. It's a 23.71, a 23.96 for Yamada. LaRue, a 24.11, the two fastest through the 300 meters. Can they keep up this pace? So a 27 dead for Yamada. That is a super quick time. Gebauer just falling away a little bit, but I think he's still in touch here. Provisional seventh place, but he might be conserving energy for the last two laps, perhaps a lap and a half when he's going to put down the power. But Yamada, wow, this is effortless from him at the moment. So still super fast, 28.84, but Gebauer looks like he's fallen off a little bit here. Yamada pushing hard. Japan sitting in first and third at the moment. He takes to the final bend. Arito Motonaga set a time of 1:50.42. Yamada Kazuya still pumping. He needs to keep going here. Oh, this is great, this is amazing. A 0.3 of a second faster than his teammate. And yet again, the track record has fallen. The fourth time today. And it's Yamada Kazuya from Japan who has set the fastest time, a 1:50.09 for the Japanese athlete. And that puts him at top of the pile. Yamada leading teammate Arito, with Canada's David LaRue completing the top three, fighting with every breath to cross the line. And there you just are, about done enough. That's the telling smile. Yep, I'm at the top, but there's one more pair to go. And guess what? There's another Japanese athlete here. Well, this final pair starts with Jakub Petrovski. And here is arguably the fastest man in the field, Nonomura Taiyo, from Japan and Senshu University. Final pair in the men's 1500. So the last pair in the men's 1500 is underway. Nonomura Daiya from Japan taking on Jakub Piotrowski from Poland. A 151.22 needs to be beaten to get onto the podium.
Good time.
So Nonomura within 8 hundredths of the fastest time through 300. Piotrowski just already starting to fall a little behind here. Nonomura means business as he cuts to the inside track, pumping those legs hard, but very smooth and consistent, very efficient work around the bend. Still within 1/100th of a second, Nonomura. You can see Piotrowski just falling behind. Nonomura currently sitting in second at that split time. Still pumping, that left arm just starting to wave around a little bit. So one full lap to go as it crosses the line, and now a tenth of a second inside the top time. Yamada leading Arito and LaRue, but Nonomura is in the hunt for the gold medal here. He's coming up the back straight, coming into the final bend, crossing over to the inside track. This is going to be super close. He was a tenth inside the time with 400 to go. He's inside the final 100 meters, pumping hard, levers propelling him along, comes across the line. Oh, it's brilliant. He saved the best for last, and Japan's Nonomura Daiya crosses the line with a 149.94. And we wait for confirmation from the scorers, but that is 0.14 of a second inside the time set by Yamada Kazuya. It was effortless from Nonomura. Absolutely effortless. Just showing signs in the final 100 meters of the work that he put in, but what work it was. Take the track record again. Confirmations come through of 149.93, and for the fifth time today, the track record has been broken, and Nonomura Taiyo of Japan tops the pile in an all-Japanese top three. Yamada Kazuya in second place with a 150.08, and Arito Motonaga in third with a 150.42. And yet again, the Japanese have something to celebrate here at the James Sheffield Olympic Skating Oval. It's been a fantastic session here in Lake Placid at the 2023 World University Games. It's been a fine day for Japan.